Welcome to Steele Nazz, Mass Music Radio's Pioneer Podcast. We're located in Quincy Point at the Mass Music Radio headquarters. On today's Christmas episode, we're joined by TV personality in the heart of Harvard University Athletics, Leverett Ball. What's up, Lev Daddy Flex?
What's up, man? You said I'm the heart of Harvard University Athletics?
PA voice, but
I'm the PA voice. No one knows. Like, I'm the heart of the Boston Red Sox. Like, what type of job is that? It's a PA voice. People haven't heard of
it. I was going to elaborate. I mean,
it's public
just
address announcer of Harvard Athletics. Although,
yeah, I hope this guy.
I did that. Fox. I did senior day for the volleyball team. And my microphone broke, so I've been having some good times there. But I'm hoping that my PA job at Harvard gets my foot in the door to be like a philosophy professor there or something. Like, I have bigger things in mind.
That's great. We'll get to you again. So public address announcer,
yeah.
Voice,
and for aspiring Harvard philosophy professor. Like, if I became a philosophy professor at Harvard,
favorite philosophy.
Dude, I would literally go up to chicks at bars and be like, hey. Like, we should talk about the meaning of life with my pants off or something. Yeah. And
I would fuck hard.
Well, Leverett, welcome to the show, man.
Leverett's this fucking big dick swinging over here.
Yeah.
Down here. We'll love Daddy Flex here and talk about how the NFL playoffs are shaking up with 2 weeks left in regular season. More importantly, what the New England Patriots odds are heading into January. Since Christmas is less than a week away, we'll give you the lowdown on what we hope to see under the Christmas tree on December 25th with our big-time Christmas list segment. We'll also have our takes and predictions on the college football playoffs that begin at the end of the next week between LSU versus Oklahoma, and going to be a big matchup here, Ohio State versus Clemson. Lastly, we'll have our weekly segments of NFL Week 16 picks, Steel Salute, Magic Mike's Minute, which, you got something in store today, Magic?
I got some magic, that's what she said.
Nice. And this week's Bonehead of the Week. All right, well, we'll get right to it, Lev. I mean, that was a nice opening by yourself.
Yeah.
You really brought out some big dick energy.
I'm sorry that I interrupted you.
No.
Yeah, I should have talked about the size of my cock after you finished introing me.
You're good.
Yeah.
That was a great. You introduced yourself better than any guest has so far.
Exactly.
Like 100%.
Yeah. So,
fuck yeah.
So, Harvard public address announcer.
Yeah.
So we're going to give you some cold, hard questions here. Kind of like some Big J action. So, what's the toughest name you've ever had to announce?
So, this was actually a basketball player named Giannis Hatsaveraglu, although this was actually at MIT, because occasionally I do basketball games at MIT when I'm not at
Harvard.
You
gotta get around freelance.
Right, but you know what? You know what's funny though? I practiced. Right, I'm trying to be a philosophy professor at both schools, but for now I'm a PA announcer. So whatever. But no. But Giannis Hatsaveraglu plays basketball at MIT. He's from Athens, Greece. But after talking to him before the game and like practicing his name and getting it down perfectly, I looked in the wrong column on the sheet for hometown, and the next player was like Christian Williams from Charlotte, North Carolina. This guy's from from Athens, Greece. I was like, Giannis Hatsaveraglu, pronounced perfectly. Like, Giannis Hatsaveraglu from Charlotte, North Carolina. And like, no one in the arena noticed, but the entire bench was like shitting their pants laughing.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so.
Bring the electricity.
They've allowed me back on campus since then, though. I'm not banned. Actually, someone asked me, because the MIT campus is open to the public. Like, you can just walk through it, it's not gated. So, this like random old man who maybe, you know, his health is declining slightly, mentally, physically, everywhere. But he asked me, he's like, he goes, are you a teacher here? And I was so flattered someone thought that I could be like a 27-year-old MIT
Wonderful.
Professor. But he didn't say professor, he said teacher, so maybe he didn't realize it's a university. Like, maybe he thought it was like Mitt Romney High School and I was like a PE teacher.
Like field trip guy.
Right, exactly. But yeah.
So I know you're a Curry College guy.
Yeah.
How'd you originally get into like, oh, I want to be a PA announcer?
Well,
the sports field.
My main job is actually television. I do PA part-time.
Oh, yeah.
But you intro me as a PA guy, so that's all we're going to talk about.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. I've also done some TV stuff with Nesson, and I was doing some Bruins radio stuff on 102.9 yesterday. I do sideline reporting. I work kind of all over the place. I have like 20 part-time jobs. Like the whole concept of like a full-time job with like a salary and benefits and like being a functional adult, like fuck that. If I knock up any girls, I'm fucked.
Day.
Like, I got
Wear
no stability. Yeah,
just gotta get
Wear
the
a condom. You
gotta get the
or
pill
there's
going.
There's
get the
plan
pill
C when you change your name to Leverett Ball. I used to have a normal name, but yeah, but
it is a baller name.
Yeah,
that sounds like a name.
I,
there. You chose
I actually have my own. I have my own
Mr.
private
Ball when you're the philosophy
yeah.
teacher.
Exactly. I'm mad, yeah.
You're going to be like, I'm balling.
I ball so hard.
Ball so hard.
I'm going to put my Leverett ball on your girl's face.
Oh, boy. This guy is something. Oh, man. Can I ask you what's prep like for game day? Like when you're,
what are you talking about, TV or like radio or PA?
What's your prep day like? You wake up. You got a big game.
So, all right.
PA, it's
how do you get ready for
your favorite
day?
Well, actually, you need to prepare more for TV than PA. But like when I'm sideline reporting, you know, you study whatever the two teams that are about to play, you know, stats, records, you know, players to watch, et cetera, and then you try to get to the field early and talk to the players off camera before the game, you know, get some quotes in or whatever. And yeah, and it's funny because like when I've done stuff with like pro sports, I watch those teams at my own time, so I don't need to study as much.
Like another day.
Right. But if you do like an obscure college or high school team, like, I one time did play-by-play announcing for college swimming. Do you think I know shit about college swimming?
No, that's tough.
Yeah. I'd be very bored if I were watching college swimming. You're just like, yeah, he's swimming through the water, and he's about
Holy shit, that guy's going faster.
He's about to Michael Phelps that hoe. You know, the funniest thing also, at swim meets, I've never seen anything like it. Like, normally when you watch sports, you're like, go! Yeah! Like, no one speaks at swim meets, and, like, at a track meet, people are like, go faster, finish! People at the swim meet, if the end of the pool is down there, they'll just stand next to the pool and go like that the whole time. And not be like, swim faster, yeah! They'll literally just go... I kid you not, every time the swimmer would jump in the water, his fans and, like, coaches and family would just be like...
So, like, place is silent?
Yeah.
It's minus you?
It's one of the most awkward things you'll ever
see.
That
sounds horrifying.
Yeah,
it's the weirdest shit ever. I actually
incredibly unenjoyable.
One time, that same day, I got to this college campus where the swim meet was happening, and I didn't know where the pool was. And then I saw two chicks in their, like, swimsuits walking to the pool for the swim meet. But granted, these were, like, onesies. Like, they looked like grandmothers.
Yeah, like
these weren't,
playing, yeah,
right,
yeah,
these
yeah.
weren't, like, bikinis.
Yeah.
So but you just fall on them, like... Really looking creepy there? Or what?
Well, no, I asked, I was like, where's the swimming pool? And they're like, come with us, hee hee hee. But nothing happened, they had a swim meet, you know, they needed to save their energy.
Yeah.
So yeah, you know, maybe I could
oh, this is college right
there. Well,
like
no, I was trying to get to my job, I was trying to be a professional, but yeah. You know, I didn't want to get fired, so I was going to be like, hey, let's practice some hip warm-ups, you know, let's do some thrusts.
It almost had to happen, man.
Some insertion.
I think you...
Some strokes.
I'm just throwing this out there, dude. You should be a PA announcer at a strip club. I think that's a better fit for you.
Imagine that. You know what's funny? So, like, when I'm in a structured environment, I behave very differently. Like, last summer, I interviewed Mayor Marty Walsh on TV, and one of my buddies saw the video on TV, and he goes, if I had never met you and I'd seen that video on TV, I would have thought you were, like, kind of sane. Like, I know how to keep my shit together at the right moments, but... But then the rest of the time, it's just like, fuck.
Just fucking winging it.
But no, imagine if I were a PA announcer at a strip club. I'm like, you know, like...
They're my favorite people in the universe.
She's got to be like, she has four children who she's trying to support. Tip her. Like, you know.
It's like take a walk.
You know, if you meet her kids, don't tell them that she sucked her cock.
Whatever, yeah. Oh, man. Yeah. So you're talking about swimming here, so I gotta ask you, because I've kind of been through the high school and college gig like that, and there are some, like, tough sports to cover, like, stuff I don't even want to put on my own social media, like swimming or, like, girls' field hockey. Like, what's your least favorite sport that you, like to announce?
Least favorite
sport.
Like,
there's some pretty bad sports. Like,
I mean, as far as obscure sports I've done, I mean, I've done volleyball, I've done swimming, I've done field hockey... Trying to think if I've done a sport that's more random than that.
What are your thoughts on curling?
I've never done curling, although I know a guy who is the NBC Olympics announcer for curling, but only curling. And it's like, is it even cool? Like, if you leave out the sport and you say, like, I'm an NBC Olympics announcer, that sounds cool, but is it even cool anymore if it's fucking curling? I don't know.
I don't know either.
But yeah, but like, but I don't know. I'm trying to think if I've done any sports. More random. I think the most random ones I've done. I mean, volleyball. I like it because it's like chicks in spandex, and fortunately they have a PA table in front of you, so it hides your excitement. You know, you don't have to have an HR meeting.
Yeah, don't get caught on TV.
Yeah, but
keep hammering, bro.
Oh, yeah, and volleyball, swimming. I don't think I have a least favorite sport. I've never announced for fencing. But, like, imagine, though, imagine I actually know another guy who does ESPN announcing for fencing. Wow. Like, imagine, though, what do you even say? You're like, he poked his fucking eye out.
He fucking stabbed him.
Or you're like, these guys are having a pretty intense sword fight. No homo. Or like, yeah. So that one would be tough.
Yeah.
What's your favorite?
It could be electric, though.
What?
What's your favorite sport?
Yeah, my favorite sport? You know what's funny? I don't have a least favorite sport. I have like a group of favorite sports, but not one. I used to play baseball, so that's maybe the easiest one because it's like I'm comfortable with the sport. I also used to play rugby. I did some sideline reporting for professional rugby on NESN. They had a bunch of pro teams from Ireland come and play a tournament in Boston, and it was on NESN. And like none of the like Bruins or Red Sox people wanted to do it, so they brought in freelancers. So I got, and because I used to play rugby, I thought it was a good fit.
Like
right. So yeah, I was doing the sideline reporting on Nesson for for rugby. That was cool.
You got a picture with Bill Belichick, I saw, right? That was pretty
cool. Yeah, he's a weird motherfucker. Like, great coach. Great coach. You know, that's probably what people say about me. They're like, that guy's a good sports announcer, but that guy kind of, you know, kind of a sick fuck.
What the fuck was up with that?
Yeah. Like, that guy probably had, like, you know, drugs in his baby formula. Something went wrong along the way. But, yeah. But, no, Bill Belichick, you know what's funny, though? He's, like, not approachable at all when he's coaching the Patriots. Like, he's a very serious guy. So I was actually, at the time, working with the Women's Professional Lacrosse League, and his daughter is a coach in the Women's Professional Lacrosse League. So he was there watching her
was
team play. His daughter?
Yeah.
She's married and has a child, and I work at the same place as her, so I cannot comment on
okay,
that.
Okay, good call.
Yeah. It's like the most mature thing I've said in my life.
That's
the most mature thing I've said in my life. Yeah.
That was blurry.
All right, I have
we
to
got
make
a new Leverett Ball.
I have to say something fucked up to compensate for that mature comment. Yeah. By the way, I just took a shit in the parking lot. All right, we're good. So, but no, but so his daughter was coaching in the Women's Professional Lacrosse League. So he was there watching her team, and like he was on his off day, like he wasn't coaching, so he was in a more chill mood. So I talked a little bit. We took a picture together, although even in a chill mood, he doesn't say much. Like, I remember I said to him, like, oh, number 10 has like 3 goals. And he's like, yes, she's doing a great job. And it was just like him on like a good day. Like, I feel as though like if like back in the day when some like smoke show girl was like, and he's in a serious relationship now, but let's say he was at like a rave back in the day and some smoke show girl was like, I just want to suck your dick all night. He'd be like, you know, that would be fine. Like, you know, like, he's just the most emotionless guy. Like, yeah. His sex face is probably like,
I would love this.
Yeah. This is fantastic. Your tits are stupendous. Yeah.
He's in a rave in a fucking cutoff hoodie.
Yeah. He's like, call me William.
The band like stops playing. He just like shuts all the lights off. Like, he's like, we need to be better than this.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Can I ask you, I don't know if you've ever called boxing before, but is there any way we could get a live call right now? Down goes the operator.
Just
Magic Mike wins. Could you
just
do
say
that?
Down goes the operator?
Yeah, just
Magic
really
Mike wins.
Like best right. PA announcer voice you got.
All right, let me send this to how I want to do this. So down goes the operator. All right, the operator called Magic Mike's mom a dirty pirate hooker, and Magic Mike just beat him into a pulp like a little bitch, and then took a shit on his face, and said, "This is nothing compared to what I'm gonna do to your next born daughter with my dick."
Oh,
how was
boy.
That?
That was good. Yeah. He put me in a body bag, bro.
Incest, that's fucked up.
This guy, he did his research on me.
Yeah.
Oh, man. So
No. I said the guy he beat up
the guy
made a comment
we,
about his mom. He's
the,
not making comments
the guy's
about his
my
mom.
Brother.
My brother. He's right there. The guy that... He's right there.
But I didn't know that was his nickname.
Yeah.
They fought a rough.
But,
they
yeah,
fought
okay.
a rough and rowdy.
Okay, I don't think that you guys call your mother a dirty pirate.
No, it was all hypothetical.
I didn't know he was your brother. Yeah,
that was awesome.
I'm sorry.
You right. went another way with that. I loved
your
it.
Your family is gonna press charges against me for defamation.
No.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. It's hilarious.
Switching the subject here. So I've been trying to get you on.
Oh, and then
the...
that would also be your niece if you're. Taking her to town. All right, whatever. I don't think you'd fuck your niece.
Don't worry about it.
All right, you would give her like over
the
top.
We're on
hugs.
To the Patriots.
No,
we're on to the Patriots.
Your Christmas
the
hugs
Patriots.
Would be a little over the top, but your penis would not be involved. All right.
No. Okay. Ball so I've been trying to get you to play on the Irish Pub softball team since you've declined many times. Will you be our PA announcer? We need a PA announcer.
But
we already got a mascot.
But that's a volunteer job. If I don't show up to play.
We'll give you 20
no,
bucks.
No, I actually time. No, but no bullshit. This is what everyone says when they don't do stuff. I actually wanted to come, but I had like a bunch of shit going on. You know, like so.
Happens.
Well, give a little excuse. I don't really buy it, but you know what?
All right.
I wanted to come, but I had shit going on.
Yeah. Says everyone that doesn't
know. I'm gonna tell that to everyone ever.
I mean, when I was busy changing my name after I didn't pull out. All right, I had shit to take care of.
And a whole new life to start.
Yeah, a whole new identity. You know.
All right, transitioning on into the New England Patriots. You know, we got two regular season games left.
Okay, but before you transition on, he would not fuck his niece. So I'll make that clear.
I wouldn't, obviously.
All right.
I mean, I would fuck his niece, but I'm not related to her, so.
There we go.
Oh, boy.
All right, now transition.
Okay. There's no way Harvard's going to hire this man.
They already did. What the fuck were they doing?
Yeah.
As a PA announcer, though, you're saying as a professor, it's not going to happen.
Yeah, maybe.
I think philosophy would be a great subject.
It would be a dirty professor.
He might make it, but I think.
I see.
If they catch wind of this interview.
Yeah. They'd be like, hire that motherfucker. That guy's.
That guy's a genius.
Yeah.
Fuck you and I. You can fuck my niece, whatever you want to
do. All right, cool. Is she hot?
I don't have one.
We'll find out. NFL playoff picture. There's two regular season games left. The Patriots are right there on the cusp of claiming the second seed. We're in the AFC East. So what do we think about the Patriots heading here against the tough Buffalo Bills defense?
So the Patriots, first off, like their receiving core. I mean, I'm sure you guys talk about this all the time. It's a fucking mess. And the only receiver they have right now, Edelman, has a fucking busted knee. He can't even like run at full speed. So they have one handicapped good receiver, and the other guys are about as talented as I am at playing receiver.
See, the past Super Bowl teams, they've had two guys they can legitimately go to. They can go to Julian Edelman and go to Rob Gronkowski. This year, you don't have Rob Gronkowski, so you need that second filler. And, I don't know, as trying to be non-biased as possible, I think if they give him enough reps, if you give the guy seven targets, I think he can get at least five of them. I think N'Keal Harry can really turn on it.
N'Keal Harry has potential.
But I think they need to use that. I mean, you see the last 2 weeks, they only threw in the ball a couple of times, and he made big plays.
So N'Keal Harry.
He's James White again, which I like.
Let me say this. So N'Keal Harry, you know, he missed so much time with the injury, and he's a rookie, so he's catching up. You know, it's like if you skip school, and then you have to study for your exam, and you're cramming. You know, N'Keal Harry is cramming right now, and N'Keal Harry, though, he's very talented. So he doesn't know what he's doing, but he's talented.
He's got some hands.
Honestly,
he runs good routes.
I don't want to overshare here, but, like, watching N'Keal Harry play football reminds me of when I lost my virginity. Because the chick was like, yeah, you have a giant dick, but you have no idea what the fuck you're doing. And, like,
it was great.
She's like, in, like, 5 years from now, you'll probably fuck hard. But this is, like, you keep stabbing the side of my leg with your dick and think it's the opening. Like, yeah.
Oh, we thought you didn't say dick today.
Huh? Would you like me to say that less often?
No, you're good.
Member,
you're good.
Private parts. Genitals.
So we like, well, obviously have problems with the Patriots offense, but how good is the Patriots defense been? I mean, Stephon Gilmore is probably the defensive player of the year. They have a couple guys who got snubbed the Pro Bowl. I think they should have had at least six guys, and they only got three.
Van Noy, dude.
Like Julian Edelman. Julian Edelman had, like, what's he get, 95 receptions, 1,100 yards? Kind of crazy.
Yeah, Julian Edelman, man, dude, he...
Love that guy.
That guy, like, when I talk about, like, N'Keal Harry reminds me of losing my virginity, watching Julian Edelman play receiver or, like, watching Stephon Gilmore play, you know, defensive back, that reminds me of my current sex life. And then, like, watching Tom Brady play is like watching, you know, someone who was a longtime porn star who gets old and has ED. So, you know what I mean? Like...
Ron Jeremy, like?
Yeah. So,
Jeremy is the GOAT.
Like, you know, you have a Will Be in N'Keal Harry, you have a starting to decline in Tom Brady, you know. So,
starting to decline.
I mean, he can still kind of play. Like, here's the other thing, I don't think he'll be on the Patriots next year, but I think he'll be in the NFL. Because if you look around the league, do you know how bad some of the quarterbacks around the league are?
That's a tough take.
Tom Brady will be better than some of the quarterbacks in the NFL when he's like 60.
I agree.
If you put Tom Brady in a wheelchair and had to throw passes from a wheelchair, he'd be better than some of the quarterbacks in the NFL. I mean, you have, like...
I don't want to lose Tom.
No. But think about, like, fucking Tom. Who are some
he's
examples.
He's going to win a Super Bowl this year. I don't know if you saw our last guest, Lights Out Lang, but he basically said if he doesn't get to go to the Super Bowl this...
Nathan Peterman, I'm pretty sure, is still an active NFL quarterback. Like, Tom Brady, he still belongs in the league. He's just not as insanely good as he used to be. So, yeah.
No, I think the like the toughest thing to do with the Patriots is beat them twice. I mean, every team that's going to be legitimate probably in the divisional round with Baltimore, they're not going to play Baltimore, but Kansas City, Houston, even if Buffalo upsets Houston, which is looking like they're going to match up in the wild card round. I really think the toughest thing to do is beat the Patriots twice in a season. I looked it up the other day. The last time they didn't make the Super Bowl, the Broncos beat them twice in the season. So I don't see it happening again. I think they can go on the road, beat the Baltimore Ravens. I think at home, I mean, they should have beat Kansas City that time. I'm not a big one on like blaming the refs, but that game, couple really bad calls. I was like,
But blame the refs because honestly,
the Kill Harry scored a touchdown.
Right. Well, and normally I think that like the Patriots during games complain too much to the refs, like Bill Belichick. Just has a bitch fit anytime, but in this case they were justified because here's the thing: not only was N'Keal Harry's touchdown, you know, called out of bounds, but they couldn't challenge it because they'd already had to challenge so many calls because that's how bad the refs were.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, you know, in 50 Shades of Grey, when he says, "I don't make love, I fuck hard," the refs fucked the Patriots hard.
Very hard.
Like that.
Yeah, like imagine like sex an arm sized penis just firm. Yeah.
Okay.
So at the end of the day, who's the team coming out of the AFC? Who's the team that's going to the Super Bowl? Non-biased opinion. Who do you think, Lev?
Either the Patriots or the Ravens.
Well, you got to pick one, man.
Okay, honestly, but this is a New England-based show.
No, that's fine.
So I'm probably going to get shanked after saying that's this, fine. But probably the Ravens.
I don't think so.
Off camera. Oh.
He's out.
You know what though? I have a strategy for the Patriots. They need to prepare to stop the running quarterback Lamar Jackson. Sign Colin Kaepernick as a scout team quarterback. Have him run all of the, you know, athletic shifty plays.
Good, I like that. I like
and
that.
Then cut him and then you're prepared.
Don't hate it.
Yeah.
Or you just throw Cody Kessler there and he'll get the job done too.
Yeah. Cody who?
He'll show up the USC Trojans right there.
Jared Stidham.
Jared Stidham.
You know, Mark James from WEEI calls him Jared Studham.
Jared Studham.
Yeah, Mark with the C.
He's not that big of a stud, though. We'll see how it goes.
We'll see.
So
His wife is sexy, though. I'll say that.
Ooh,
yeah. Have you seen his Instagram?
No surprise there.
Yeah. His, like, pictures of him and his wife are, like, porn. Anyway, continue.
So we talked about the AFC a little bit, more about the Patriots. Who do you see coming out of the NFC?
I mean, I think the Saints are always
the thing about that, anyone can get beat except whoever wins the NFC East this week, whether it's Philly or the Cowboys. Anyone can win that, but those two teams, they're probably either playing the Seahawks or the Niners in the wild card round, and they're going to get pumped by whoever they play. I think the Cowboys win this week. We'll join that later in our gambling segment. But at the end of the day, I think New Orleans is the one who can really take it from the top because they have so much experience, especially with the quarterback position. And I haven't seen a year in a wide receiver in quite some time in Michael Thomas. I mean, I'm playing in my fantasy league championship, and the guy who I'm playing, shout out to Ryan Nagel there, he's got Michael Thomas, and he's projected like 27 points.
He
like
might have 150 reception.
That's like insane. That's like absolute blasphemous. I mean, another shout out to Stephen A., but I'll leave it there. Yeah. So New Orleans, who do you like, Steele?
Seahawks? Ooh. Oh, yeah, Seahawks, dude. Like, look at the list, dude. Rams, Goff sucks. Yeah. Minnesota, Kirk Cousins sucks.
Well, Rams ain't
Dallas,
gonna make it.
Dak,
I just put it in there because of
last
seed.
Drew Brees, very good. Seattle will beat them. Aaron Rodgers, bum. Jimmy Garoppolo, gonna chill.
Well, I think the big thing that comes to that with, like, your prediction of the Seahawks, because the San Fran plays the Seahawks week 17. The winner of that is probably going to be the number one seed in the whole NFC.
Yeah, Seattle's number one right now because they've already beat San Fran.
I think you make a good point. I'm still going to stick with New Orleans, but I think the winner of that game has a great chance going to the Super Bowl. Magic Mike, do you have a take here, or are we just going to move on to the next one?
No, I'm going to stick with, I think it'll be 49ers-Patriots in the Super Bowl.
Ooh, that's a good one. I like that.
It'll be Tom versus his
and that's what everyone wants to see. I like that. I like
you know what, though?
What I want, what they want.
If the Niners and Patriots went up against each other in the Super Bowl, though, Belichick wanted to keep Garoppolo and get rid of Brady, and Kraft made him get rid of Garoppolo. But what if Belichick was so petty and was like, I have so many Super Bowl rings already, I will lose on purpose to Garoppolo to prove that I was right. Imagine that. Just imagine. And he wouldn't actually do that.
Would be such
he's
a
not he's
weird
not
move.
He's
did,
not
did he
okay.
Tell you he was going to do that when you saw him?
Exactly. But no, he's not he's not petty enough to lose on purpose, but he was petty enough to bench his best defensive player in a Super Bowl just to prove a point.
See, I think there's more into that. From what I heard through the grapevine, happened with Steve Belichick and Malcolm Butler. I'll leave it
there. Yeah, what a coincidence. Yeah. The DB coach that he butted heads with was Belichick's son.
And how do you think he butted heads there?
I have a little source there
that I'm probably gonna leave it off the mic, but
did you see Steve Belichick's interview where he like sounded exactly like his dad?
Yeah. Why don't you do your Belichick voice again?
My Belichick voice?
Yeah, so
You know what's funny? I remember I did a podcast over the summer right after Patrick Chung got arrested for Yes. No. Well, this was actually like a podcast I recorded at my home. But a little bit, yeah. But and drugs and shit. But anyway, no. I did a podcast right after Patrick Chung got arrested for possession of cocaine. And I remember saying, like, of all the awkward conversations to have, can you imagine talking to Bill Belichick about how you got caught with coke? Like, that's got to be pretty fucking awkward. And you asked me to do my Bill Belichick voice. Like, I can just picture Bill Belichick in that meeting being like, well, Patrick, I hear you're in love with the cocoa. And he's like, baking soda. Patrick has baking soda. Yeah. And Patrick Chung actually got to play this season, but they took away his team captaincy. So, I don't know. But
loves the stuff, man.
But can you imagine that, just talking to Bill Bell? Of all the things, like, you know, of all the awkward situations, like having your parents walk in when you're tugging it, like, I'd rather have that happen than have to talk to Bill Belichick about how he got caught with coke. Yeah. Can you imagine? 100%. And Bill's like, you know, that stuff is unacceptable, but back in my day, I was wild.
I was watching the show Ray Donovan today, and, like, have you seen Ray Donovan? Anyone see that?
No,
but, like, the son, like, the wife walked into the son fucking his couch. Mm. And I was like, wow, that's something. That's
fucking a couch.
I mean, shout out to Alex Baptista, but we'll leave it at
that. Let's go!
That reminds me of the Blue Mountain State episode where they call him Couch.
Oh, yeah, that's a big one.
Yeah, because he fucked a couch.
Yeah. All right, well, we're going to transition on from the NFL and the Patriots. Since it's the Christmas episode, I feel like we're going to get a little festive this week.
Mm-hmm.
We want to tell you our all-time things that we want on the tree this year, even though if it ain't going to happen. But I think it does happen. I think Santa comes by. Santa's here. Want a hat?
Yes.
Daddy's home.
You want a hat?
And he's been drinking. Yeah, I'll take a hat.
Do it. Oh, actually, this one doesn't really fit on my head. I've got a giant noggin.
This one might fit.
Let's go. Oh, this one's adjustable.
This thing's sick.
It's lit.
What did you get, Steele?
I got a coon hat. Let's go.
Ness, do I get to keep this, or are you going to, like, tackle me in the parking lot and take it back?
I might tackle you here.
Okay.
I got to work him out. I got to see if Belichick's actually outside. I want to
so
get on the
since
defense.
We're in, you know, the mode of talking about holidays, so obviously some people celebrate Christmas, some people celebrate Hanukkah, but what is the winter Scientologist holiday? Like, what is Tom Cruise turning up about right now? Do you know?
Probably the next Mission Impossible movie is going to be in, I would think. That's probably on his Christmas list.
Remember how Tom Cruise, he had that whole spiel where he, like, went on TV and argued with Matt Lauer?
It's fine, you're good.
I got it. This is my Christmas hat.
Were you wearing that before?
Sexy.
Never.
Okay, good. I was like, I'll take that.
Thank you, though.
No problem.
I keep this since you stole another hat, you fucking
guy. Yeah, so we all picked a couple Christmas presents. Won't be under. I'll start first. I mean, I've seen the kid wear it. Kid was a big time at Rough and Rowdy. I want a seersucker for Christmas. That's what I want.
Oh, man.
I want a seersucker soup. I mean, I can get beautiful. It for myself because I'm Santa. But, like, I need the right size. December 25th. You know, if I can really get to... What's a big place to get? Milton's.
And right now, the good thing about Milton's, Nazz, is I got mine around this time of the year, too, because I was heading to Aruba. And they're discounted. So you could probably get a seersucker like mine for probably $70. Ooh. Cheap stuff.
I'll have to tell myself that because I'm Santa right
tell
now.
Tell Santa seersuckers are in season right now. Get them cheap. Yeah. Get them all the cheap.
What do you want for Christmas?
I want a 2-foot-tall Paul Curtin. I could have it, dude. Anything, dude. I could. It could grab me beers. We could take it down to Kavanaugh. We could kick field goals with it. Do anything, dude.
Paul Curtin's one of our friends.
Paul could kick Paul Curtin for a field goal, see if it goes over.
He's better than the Young Ho.
Yes.
Except for onside kicks. I've never seen that.
Yeah.
That guy's like elite onside kicker.
He is an Asian. Young Ho's
gotten better at field goals. He had that rough game, but he's actually started to hit them more. He does more now than just kick onsides and recover fumbles. Do you see that?
He fucks bitches and gets money.
Yeah.
Asian at Notre Dame. He's definitely killing it.
Hey, yeah, Young Ho probably fucks a lot of young hoes.
Ooh. Love that.
See what I did there? So creative.
That's we did that thing on episode one, but damn it. I still appreciate it.
I crack myself up.
Yeah.
You've been great all show.
You know what, though? When I was studying, I watched a few episodes. I think the one that I missed was episode one. God damn it.
What a piece of shit.
I know.
I like that.
But I appreciate you watching, though.
Magic Mike, I want to know, which one, what's your Christmas present you want?
I want a philosophy class and with Leverett Ball teaching.
Yeah.
Like that, I need a philosophy. Did I say it right?
Leverett
Ball. Yeah. Leverett Ball. It's fake name. It's your second name anyway.
Exactly, so right. My name is
Williams. More of a Lev Daddy Flex guy.
I need a Lev Daddy Flex philosophy class. Philosophy is my favorite subject.
Well, you know, here's the thing, though. I think that people just misunderstand life. Like, they're always talking about, like, getting a degree, getting a job, you know, having a clean criminal record. Like, just do your thing.
Yeah.
So you've basically been arrested, been fired a couple times. I'm not blaming you.
I killed
you.
A guy once.
You changed your name for a
reason. He was talking shit. If he hadn't talked shit, he'd be alive. It's his fault. Yeah.
If I can ask for one more thing,
I
want a class with him.
Motherfucker.
I want a class with him, and then I want a night out with him at the strip club. And then I'm satisfied for Christmas.
No, those places are degrading to women. All right, let's go to a jazz bar.
Yeah. Okay. Snap some fingers, man.
Actually, no bullshit. They would let you into a jazz bar in that outfit, dude. You would fuck at a jazz bar in that outfit.
Thank you. All right,
imagine if you're performing at a jazz bar in that outfit.
I could. This is a jazz.
Or what is it even? A piano bar? Jazz bar? I don't fucking know. I don't actually go to those places.
What do you want for Christmas, Leverett?
I would like some after party accessories. So, like, a couch that's big enough that if you, like, you know, bring a nice Uber full of women home with you from the club, they can all fit on it. Because no bullshit.
So you just want a couch that's big enough to fuck on?
No. I'm saying, like, I want, like, if I bring a group full of girls home from the club, and I'm fucking the hot one, I want a nice comfortable couch for her friends to sit on.
What you really want is a big booty hoe. That's what you want.
No, I want equipment that helps me in my recruitment of big booty hoes.
Oh, they're back. There we go.
Welcome.
I thought I scared them away. They're this guy keeps talking about, like, knees fucking.
No, you didn't scare
stuff,
them away. So what do you want? What do you want for Christmas? I still don't know. What do you want for Christmas?
I think it's a big booty hoe. Like that's what it is.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, multiple hoes. Plug it on, I guess. I don't know.
Ho ho ho.
Yeah. Like Santa Claus. Yeah. Exactly.
My pick that I want for Christmas, I want a fucking seventh ring. I want February come around. You ever get a Pressman? I want more. I want more.
I want my club January 31st in Miami. That's what she said. Give them to me.
No,
feed them me.
Have you ever gotten something for Christmas and it's like, yeah, it's not coming until February? That's what I want. I want February 3rd, I think, is the Super Bowl. I want a Patriots 7th ring. I think Brady will retire on that note. He will not go to the Chargers or whatever the fucking fuss is.
Yeah. No, he's going to play arena football for the Massachusetts Pirates.
Oh, let's go. I like that. Give me that.
The odds of that are low.
That was fucking weak.
No,
do that again.
The odds of that are low, but if it actually happened, I would be the only person who predicted it, and people would be like, dude.
That motherfucker,
you know,
over there.
All right, harder high five.
Yeah.
Yeah, come on.
I was trying to talk to him and high five at the same time, and it was kind of came out like, yeah.
Well, maybe do one and then the other, which you did, but fuck it.
Yeah.
All right, everyone get their Christmas list in. Anyone want any more?
I think we're good. Anything else? I still don't know what he wants, but everyone else, great gift.
Yeah, you never even asked me, Dick. Well,
you did.
I want a couch for girls from the club. No,
yeah. No, you want a big booty hoe. You said a couch.
No,
but
I want a couch.
But then you started talking about girls. It's definitely more of a big
booty
hoe. Like, what's that?
Yeah. I wish we had a sponsorship with Jordan's Furniture, because that would imagine
15%
off Jordan's Furniture. They'll sponsor it.
Imagine if I was in the Jordan's Furniture ads and it was like
couches.
It was like,
well, you know,
it'd be like me smiling. It's like, buy some furniture to get fucked on. Yeah.
Shout out to Jordan's Furniture. I mean, even Bernie and Phil's, you know.
Yeah, Bernie. That's Bernie. We'll take a subpar for, you know, second rate fucking furniture. We'll take it. I don't give a fuck. Sponsor us. We need sponsors. We need to make money. Our parents are wondering what we're doing here. All right.
And we will move on to the annual steel salute of the night.
Garrett motherfucking Cole, baby.
Boo! Fuck them! Fuck them!
Boo!
Yankees, 162-0. It's going to be amazing.
You're going to lose the first round.
And O.
You signed a guy for 9 years, 324 mil.
He's going to win the Cy Young, and he's going to be great.
He's making 36 mil when he's 38. And
that's
fucking
fine. It ain't my money. I don't give a shit about the money. There's no salary cap in baseball. He's just going to pitch, and we're going to win World Series.
The Yankees can afford it, though. They have the money to, like,
yes.
give a guy a long-term deal beyond
what
he's
worth. I sound like I don't
think
they're going to do that.
You do sound.
He's a loser. He lost and immediately said, I don't play for this team anymore. He's going to do the same thing when you guys lose this year. He's a phony.
But he can't.
He was the better pitcher in the regular season this year, and they were like, you know what? He's kind of a little bitch. We're gonna give it to fucking Verlander, and that's exactly what they did. Who was the better pitcher this year, Verlander or Garrett Cole?
The one with like 330 strikeouts.
Garrett
Cole. ERA, yes.
And he didn't win it because he's a fucking suckbag.
Because his name
I use the
Justin
word again.
Verlander.
Suckbag.
His name isn't Justin Verlander, so they picked Justin Verlander.
Steele, if you shaved your beard, do you think you could come on this show with as much swag and throw a 100-mile-per-hour fastball?
We'll find out in June. Bruins in four. We'll find out in June.
That's wishful thinking. I think the answer is no, though. I think you'd lose
some
swag.
We'll find out, brother.
I agree.
We'll find out.
You wouldn't look as sexy in that Davy Crockett hat right now if you didn't have a beard.
I'm fucking keeping this.
He looks unsexy in those pinstripes with no beard. He looks like a jamuk.
I'm calling it right now. The Boston Red Sox and the destruction they have this offseason. Shout out to the Rays. They're really doing it. I saw that guy, the outfielder, the Asian guy, doing pretty well. I think the Yankees.
Say his name.
You think I know his fucking name?
Call me daddy.
Yeah. I think the Red Sox finish above the Yankees this year. Hot take here, but I think it really happens.
I think the Red Sox will be 25 games back of the Yankees.
Well, and if you're talking about 25. Yankees free agent signings, we've never forgotten when Johnny Damon broke our hearts and left.
How about Jacoby Foxx?
No, but who gives a shit about him? He always gets hurt. But could you ever imagine Mookie one day signing long-term with the Yankees?
No. I think he gets traded to the Dodgers. I think it happens. Oh, we got a Rays fan in the building. What's up, Anton?
And I never think you would call your mother a
the
dirty pirate.
The Rays will also be 8.
That's what I should have told me.
You guys are brothers before I met you.
The guy who looks
Jesus
just like
Christ.
Me.
So, yes, no,
this
my
is
mom,
fucked up.
My mom is not a
dirty
person.
All right, dirty. It was he called her a dirty
person. Susie's a great person.
I love her. Yeah.
Yeah.
My mom, we're close.
You also wouldn't call your mother a dirty pirate.
Never.
Yeah.
Never.
So, all right, we brought our Rays insider on. What you wanted to come on here? You wanted to say something? What's your take?
Say his name.
Garrett Cole is the best pitcher on the planet.
The C here.
Exactly. Why didn't he win the Cy Young then? Because he's an asshole.
Because baseball writers are just love to just
yeah, Barry
numbers.
Bonds isn't in the Hall of Fame, dude.
Are you kidding me? How did Ken Griffey Jr. not get 100% fucking voted into the
baseball
Hall of Fame?
That guy should be killed.
Yeah.
That's a completely different conversation.
No, it's not.
You know, yes, it is.
No, are we transitioning this into Hall of Fame debates?
We're talking about baseball.
Curt Schilling.
Yeah.
Should he be in the Hall of Fame?
Yes.
What do you
think?
Yes.
That's from a Yankees fan. He should be.
You know what? I think he should be in the Hall of Fame. I also think he's a douchebag.
That was fucking catch up
he's,
on his sock,
sure.
though.
Sure.
Yeah.
That guy's a fucking
the thing, Roger Clemens. Should Roger Clemens be?
Yes. Okay, well, all right. There's this
time out, though. I like what you did with you're a basketball guy, a hockey guy. You guys just changed on the fly. That's big time.
There's two ways to look at the Hall of Fame. It's either you're pro the steroid guys, and then you're going to vote the steroid guys, or you're anti, and they're nowhere to be seen. So if you're pro that, if you're going to vote that, and you're say, fuck it, why not? I mean, we're just not even going to punish the Astros. Why not?
Well, yeah. Here's the other thing. If you talk about,
if you talk about
guys who got caught with PEDs, there are plenty of guys who have taken PEDs and not gotten caught. Like, you know, having a clean record doesn't mean you're clean. Like the whole thing is a mess.
How many Hall of Famers do you think haven't gotten caught though? How many in the actual?
Well,
Hall of
Frank
Fame
didn't Frank
caught?
Thomas in his speech talk about how I was clean the whole time because he never tested positive.
Sure, but that's one out of how many?
We came on to talk about your Rays. What's going on with that?
Let's talk about my
You just signed that
25
that
games
yeah,
back.
Okay,
nine
fine.
Games
I'm
back,
not
even Yankees in
love
four.
The signing. It's great.
What's his full? If you're a big Rays fan, what's his full name?
Don't worry about his name.
Ah, yeah, see, is he real?
Is he
real? I don't know.
Say
his name.
Say
my name.
I'm a Japanese veteran.
Long time,
like whole life.
Yeah.
So you were around to see when Carl Crawford was good. Because when he came to Boston, he turned into a little bitch.
He was one of the – he was literally – I love that speed guy, like the Trey Turner, the Jacoby Ellsbury. Jacoby Ellsbury was one of the most valuable players to that Red Sox team.
There's no need to speak that name.
I think Carl Crawford was amazing. And the fact that he just sucked with Boston. The fact that David Price won a World Series –
does hurt. Like, one of the worst days of my life, sports fan-wise, was when Evan Longoria got traded. The second was, like, David Price winning World Series. Like, fuck.
And the guy who they said could not pitch in the postseason finally got it done.
Yeah, I mean, it is what it is.
He finally did it.
He's a good pitcher. He's a great fucking pitcher. He had enough. I respect. Fine. We got Snell. We got some slapdick prospects. I'm ready.
Ready to go.
I'm ready to go. We have the best prospect.
How's Glashnow's arm feeling?
What do you mean? If the Astros weren't tipping pitches, did you not? That was the most noticeable time.
Yeah, Astros didn't blatantly cheat.
We beat them. And then the Yankees are
blatantly cheap.
And then we have Snell back, healthy, Cy Young.
No brainer.
Whatever the odds are. That's
so Rays win the division? Is that what you say?
You know what? I'm a realistic fan. No. I mean, Garrett Cole is legit. 8 games back. Garrett Cole's legit. Red Sox are
back. So you're saying the Rays 8 games back? You're saying the Sox, she's at
25? Yes. 25? I did not stutter.
No,
I'm not going to say
that. We'll see you next September. We'll see what happens.
I'm not going
to
say that.
On that note, we're going to transition on to the Medeiros Minute. Big shout out to the king of Squantum here, Jim Hines. You know, raising a great kid. I'll leave it at that. Let's go, baby. It's Nazz here. We're in the holiday season of things. And, I mean, you have to see here, I grew my beard out, you know. I mean, it only took, I think, like 12 hours. But you know what? We're here in the Medeiros Minute. I'm not sure what's going on here, but they're in front of someone's house. I have no clue where it is. What's up, Magic Mike? Where are you guys at?
I'm out here with Gardner Minshew. He's back. And I brought my good friend, new friend, Mr. Ball So Hard. Bitches need to suck his dick.
Yeah. Good idea. What he said.
And we're just out here. We're brown bagging it. I think we're on the way to the Atlanta strip club, right?
Nice ladies need to have relations with me is what he meant to say. Yeah.
Heading towards Atlanta. I got my game on Sunday. Told you, absolutely blowing that game. Hammer at Atlanta.
You're going to blow it on purpose.
Oh, absolutely blow this.
You're
going to
blow all your money on the bitches.
And then after, I'm going to go straight to Magic City. Blow probably $50,000.
Where the hell's Magic City?
Magic City's the best club in fucking Atlanta. You ever heard of it?
King of Diamonds?
Oh, nah.
Magic City, you know that place? King of Diamonds is awful.
I've
had a lot of adventures there, which, you know, I'm trying to keep on the down low.
What's the most amount of money you've spent at a strip club?
I really wish you didn't bring up this topic, Gardner.
I mean, this one chick, I could see her, like, bush kind of growing out of her panties, and I just couldn't stop throwing hundreds, and that was when I lost my house.
What?
So I now sleep in an RV.
Shout out to everyone living in an RV out there, man. Tough day.
You know what? He's done it before. Hey, Uncle Rico did it with you before. Remember that time?
I work long hours in my car. Sleeping in your car is not that bad.
It ain't that bad. I've slept in my car in La Jolla, San Diego. It's fucking better than sleeping in the bedroom that I beat my brother's ass for. Fuck that shit. Let's keep rolling, boys.
It was 8 degrees last night. I slept like a baby.
Where? In Atlanta?
No, I'm in Brookline.
Who knows where we are? What the fuck's the matter? We're getting laid tonight, boys. Where's your brown bag?
Dude, if you were homeless and you lived in your car and then became an Uber driver, and then when chicks asked you what do you do, you're like, I'm kind of a big deal. I work from home. See what I did there?
If I was homeless, you just gotta stop walking towards Florida. Why are you staying there?
Yeah.
It's fucking freezing.
Take a train to Cali. I might be homeless tomorrow and honestly do a hard day's work outside and get $100, get an Amtrak or whatever the hell train to take to Cali, and I'm living better.
I fall asleep with the window open, I'm fucking frozen solid.
Remember the movie Pursuit of Happiness, where there's that scene when Will Smith and his son get back to the building and their landlord has locked them out because he never pays his rent? That's happened to me, except minus the kid part, because like I don't really, I'm not involved in the lives of my kids. But like, it's more like that thing, except it's like a white guy by himself instead of a black guy and his kid.
Okay.
All right. What do you want for Christmas under the tree?
I don't know. Okay, to learn how to pull out or pay child support, because I've struggled with both.
How much do you think child support would be for you every month?
If I hadn't changed my name, fuck. I mean, I'm already homeless from my stripper
habit. Honestly, how much do you think you'd have to pay?
Including sperm donations or just women I've had sex with?
Sperm donations?
Donating your blood does not include
sperm, like tugging yourself into a cup.
No, it doesn't count.
That doesn't count. No, legally, you don't
have to. You've never done that, Gardner?
I don't get 1099 on that. I'm from Florida. We bust nuts like it's busting gas. You know what I'm saying?
That's fair. That's fair.
Where's your jockstrap, Gardner?
My jockstrap is actually right here at all times. I'm just always prepared.
Yeah.
Just gotta he's have packing. It ready.
He's ready.
Come on. I don't know. Cup check,
you know? You feel like showing the full show or what?
Hey, you ever seen the full Nelson?
I don't want to.
Merry Christmas!
I'm not gonna smack it. We're gonna be smacking as a big booty host tonight.
Hey.
That's what Dad said. That's what Mr. Christmas. Ball so hard said. That's what Gardner said.
I thought we had known on that.
No, no, we ain't done. We can be done. You want to be done?
Nah. Well, so
I still got a little beer left.
Yeah. What are you rocking? You want to just hand me these beers?
Yeah, let's
just say Merry Christmas.
Hey, Merry Christmas.
Keep the change of filthy animals. Die Hard is actually a Christmas film.
Yes, it is.
If no one supports that.
Yes, it is.
Still a big fan of that.
And Gardner Minshew's dick is bigger than Big Dick Nick's. That's an obvious fact.
Happy holidays.
And
fuck yeah.
Ball so hard. Love them.
I already finished my beer, pussies.
Thank you, Minshew Season and Magic Mike, for that minute, man. That was some great shit right there, man. Really appreciate that stuff. So now we're going to transition on. Thanks, Mike. Appreciate that, man. We're going to transition on into the college football playoff preview. I mean, our next show isn't for 2 weeks, so we might as well bring it up because the games we've played. Well, we got LSU, number one seed, Joe Burrow, Heisman Trophy winner, facing Jalen Hurts transfer, and they just sneaked in there, number four seed Oklahoma. Steele, who are you thinking on this one?
Oh, LSU by a billion.
I mean, it's minus 14. You think they're going to cover that spread?
Yes. Ronnie Perkins is suspended. He's their most consistent rusher, defensive end on Oklahoma.
Yep.
It's already a Big 12 defense, and Joe Burrow is going to fucking rip him to shreds.
This is our college insider, Steele, here. He's the one with the noise. I think LSU is going to blow the brakes off of them.
Yeah,
they play Georgia in the SEC game, and the championship game, and they made them look like a Quincy Youth Little League team. I was like, I saw the like West Quincy Elks go there and just get demolished. Like that's how it got.
Like Jalen Hurts will they'll have a little bit more fucking backlash than Georgia did. They'll score a few points on them, but it's not going to be close.
It's in Hot Atlanta too. I mean, there's a lot of nice strip clubs down there, right, Leverett?
Oh, absolutely. But you know what though about Jalen Hurts? Do you think maybe he has a bone to pick as far as big games? What happened with him before he transferred, with Tua taking his job? In the biggest moment of all time, maybe he'll be a Jalen Hurts that we've never seen, and he'll put a hurtin' on him. See what I did there? Ha ha!
I agree what you said there, but not against LSU. I think LSU's got a good enough defense where it's going to be too much offense size, not enough.
Okay, LSU gave Shaquille O'Neal a master's degree, so I'm not impressed by them.
That's
boom roasted.
They're good at football.
Yeah. Shaq would fuck you up.
He'd beat me in a fight, yeah. Probably.
Fair to say?
Yeah.
Would probably be
I think at the end of the day, I think Jalen Hurts already won this bid here of him transferring because he's in the college football playoff and Alabama's playing Michigan in some bowl game who no one even knows what the name is.
Michigan. Bama's not going to show up at all. they don't give a fuck.
Yeah, Shea Patterson was like, oh, we're they haven't beat anyone good.
Is Prez Bagwell's gonna be happy after this fucking Michigan?
I think it was Michigan Big Ben from there. He was like, Bama is not gonna give a fuck about that bowl game.
Really?
Yeah, dude, that's national championship at Boston, Alabama. Like, they don't give a shit about that bowl game.
You're right.
So we got LSU.
Michigan blows too.
We got LSU by over 14 points. So take the spread, LSU, no brainer. And the real game that we're all talking about here, the 2-3 seed in the PlayStation Fiesta Bowl in Glendale, Arizona. Who do we like here? We got undefeated number 2, Ohio State, against number 3, Clemson, 13-0, the defending national champions. Who do we like here?
Ohio State. This one's going to be very close.
Ooh, that's where we
I agree with you. Trevor Lawrence, not only does he look like a teenage girl, but he can't handle the Buckeyes this time around.
Yeah, no, I don't think he's got it one bit.
Nope.
Dobbins and fucking Fields, that offense with that defense, Chase Young is going to eat Sunshine up. Eat him up. Maybe force that.
See, I completely Sunshine. Disagree.
Hey,
I think Clemson, they've been knocked for not playing anyone all year, and they've beaten they beat the brakes off every team. They beat every team by 30 points.
They beat North Carolina by one.
Yeah, but that was one game. Everyone has a tough one game. And I know saying this, it's going to contradict what I just said, but the Big Ten championship game, Wisconsin was winning for most of the time. I think. I think it's gonna be. I think it's gonna be a Clemson win. I think they're gonna advance. It's gonna be SEC against ACC in the national championship. So I think that's what it's gonna be all about. I think it's gonna be Clemson, LSU. I think that's the name of the game. So you're saying LSU, Ohio State?
It is a robbery to fans of college football if Ohio State does not play LSU.
So what do we put on the line then? What do we put on the line? I'm going to take Clemson. You're going to take LSU. The spread's two, but we're going to forget about that since we're going to – what do you want to bet on? What do you want to do?
I don't know.
Want to do $20?
Yeah, sure.
Want to do $200?
Yeah, no. Come on, guys. $200. Take some favor. Lever, what do you want to – what do you want to bet on it?
Oh, all kinds of things.
I'll bet your bitch versus my bitch.
Hey.
Is that your toy?
But I don't want yours.
Is that your toy?
No, I'm just kidding. I would definitely hook up.
I don't even got one for him.
All right, so what's the steepest you'll go?
You don't got one either?
I have like some side ones. $50 right here. You know, like some people are like,
go Tigers, baby. Go Tigers.
He's got freelancers.
Yeah.
All right, I'll take one of your.
Not the end of the whole like exclusive relationship shit. That's kind of
like. That is like legit. Yeah.
I know, but they're a good team. They got a strong Tinder defense. They have really good wide receivers. They're saying that receiver is going.
You can tell girls on Tinder you're mean. That's what you get if you
Virginia
win.
Virginia is the best team they play. Virginia.
So college football playoff. I'm taking Clemson, LSU. And I think the rest of the board is taking Ohio State, LSU.
No, I'll say this. I think Oklahoma will beat LSU, and I think that Ohio State will beat Clemson.
Love it.
And then Trevor Lawrence will have this like life-changing moment. It'll be like, I need to get a fucking haircut and stop being a little bitch. Then they'll be like, oh my God, Clemson has a new quarterback. It's a man.
It might be onto something.
I don't hate it.
It's possible.
Did you see Trevor Lawrence in the Victoria's Secret fashion show? Oh, sorry, that was Giselle. Sorry.
Would you bang Trevor Lawrence?
I mean,
sounds like it's almost getting there.
Hey, you
is he
know.
Close enough? She close enough?
Well, it's 2019, almost 2020.
Well, transition on.
I know who Trevor Lawrence is. I heard that whisper over there. Fucking Anton. So I'm sick of him.
We'll transition on into the bonehead of the week, since all these guys are boneheads.
There's a guy who wants to be on here.
Oh, we got him.
Let's get some shit talking.
So my bonehead of the week, it's not just one person, it's the whole franchise. The Oakland Raiders, the last game ever in Oakland, and they blew a 13-14 point lead against the Jacksonville Jaguars. Now joining the show, reoccurring guest, Gardner Minshew. What's going on, man?
Yeah, how are you?
I'm good.
Let's talk to you guys.
So let me put it out for you. Oh, great to see you, pal. What's going on? Welcome so back. We'll put it in thank retrospect you, here. So the last game ever in Oakland, you know those fans, they're painting themselves, they're really getting going, and then you guys are trailing by 14 points heading the fourth quarter, outscore them in the fourth quarter. Doesn't even go to overtime. There's a controversial Derek Carr, like, slide-in, slide-out type thing. But bottom line, Gardner, you came back. You brought the troops back. Big Dick Nick is on the bench, and how do you feel?
Oh, I knew. It was our last game at home. I just knew I had to whip it out. Smash his cock out, you know, big it, whatever it is. I'm the starting QB. You know I had to win it. Came back at the home.
There it is. There let me it talk is. About you know how... I mean? Had to put it down. I'll put it all down on
these lovable losers. Since coming back to Oakland in 2005, they've made the Super Bowl once. And other than that, they've lost a shit ton. They've barely made the playoffs. I mean, big shout out to Rich Gannon. That guy's a legend. But, I mean, Derek Carr going to Vegas, I just don't see it. They think they're going back to Nick Foles, I think, next year because he's making over 100 mil. You know what? I like Gardner Minshew in Vegas. What do you think about that, Gardner?
Only thing I have to say is I'm probably going to lose every single other game of the year. I just have to say, absolutely hammer the Falcons. I'm going to absolutely blow this game. Yeah. I just want the top pick of next year, highest pick in the draft I can get a wide receiver. 2020. Bet the Jaguars.
Yeah.
You know what? I honestly think
hammer the house.
I like that Southern accent. Jaguars. I like that. That's good.
No, you know what, Nez?
Jags, baby. Jags.
Nez, if Alex Moran were a real person and he were an NFL draft prospect, his pro comparison would be Gardner Minshew. Absolutely.
I think Garner's way cooler than him.
He just doesn't have a soul patch like I do.
True.
Gardner likes to let it rip, baby. That's what we're all about. Shout out to Anton over there. Yeah. All right. Well, we will transition on to our NFL picks. I'm glad you're in here, Gardner, because, I mean, some guy from the Arizona Cardinals just got suspended indefinitely next year for gambling. How do you feel about that?
I obviously think gambling just become a bigger topic in American sports. It's on ESPN, says it under the scoreboard.
The Ocho.
Just rip the house. Always hammer the over. Life's too short to bet the under.
Yeah, what are you doing? You know what I mean?
You know? why are we out here for?
So my first pick of the night, I'm going to take the Kansas City Chiefs because I think they're going to win out and put a lot of pressure on the New England Patriots. I got them -6 over Chicago. Chicago's got no offense. If you can't keep up with Pat Mahomes and their... I know they got a good defense, but if you can't keep up with Pat Mahomes and their offense, they're in big trouble. I'm going to take Kansas City -6 over the Chicago Bears. Book it. What's up, Steele?
I got Houston -3 over the Buccaneers. No Mike Evans, no nothing. Buccaneers are dead.
Rashad Perriman, baby.
Yeah.
The fantasy football pickup, number one. I'm telling you, man, bet against the Buccaneers because you don't know what's going to come.
And I'm going to accept that I'm going to have like Houston beat them.
I'm pretty sure Jameis Winston is in the top two in TD passes, and he's number one by like 9 in like interceptions.
Yeah,
like so it's literally like the love and hate of like someone. Like if you know that person at home, if you know like anyone that's really like a good person, but in heart they're just like a degenerate shitbag. I mean, that's your guy there, Jameis Winston. I mean, he got crab legs. He got a Heisman Trophy, national championship.
Don't even get me started on Jameis Winston. Yeah, like, Jameis Winston makes me look like a respectable human being. Like, I mean, the guy's a fucking bum.
After what we've heard, like, I'm not denying that.
The guy isn't even allowed to take fucking Uber because he's such a creep. Yeah, banned from the Uber app. Actually, you know what's funny? My old Craigslist roommate was banned from Uber, but not from being a weirdo. No, so he literally, I met him on move-in day. This guy was such an idiot that anytime he got drunk, this dude would call Ubers, and instead of canceling them, he would wait to tell the driver in person that he didn't need the ride. Like, when he was drunk, so he would call Ubers,
and then be like,
I just want to tell you in person, I don't need your services.
Who are you texting?
Like, one night, he did that 7 times in a row, and he got permanently banned from using Uber. So then he had to, like, text people and be like, I'm at such and such place. Can you send an Uber my way, and I'll Venmo you?
Fuck.
Yeah. Unless you're Jameis Winston or this kid, it's pretty fucking hard to get banned from taking Uber.
No, that's hard to do.
Yeah.
Does anyone have a gambling pick, or should I go again?
All I have to say is absolutely hammer the Atlanta Falcons. I'm going to absolutely blow this game. So,
yeah, Falcons by a trillion.
Leverett, what team do you have getting absolutely
Atlanta strip clubs? Magic Mike's asking you.
Bagwell this weekend.
I think, well... So wait, Nez, you've been doing the fucking topics out of order. Where the fuck are we in the script right now?
We're in the conclusion, man.
I mean, my reading ability is kind of blow to begin
script.
With. He's been, this okay, ain't a script. In the outline, in the fuck out. He's been like, okay, here, all over the fucking place. This is
uncut.
I compared N'Keal Harry running a route to me losing my virginity. That's been Nez's hosting today.
That was topic three.
This is the first time a guest has gone back at us.
We're at topic 7.
What the fuck?
We're doing a good job here. You just won't.
And listen. I'm just for Christmas.
I'm just trying to be dramatic.
Breaking news. Can Leverett Ball read?
Probably. Not really. I went to Curry College. That's
Fun
how we
fact,
met.
No.
That's how we met at Curry College. You think I learned how to read at fucking Curry College?
Leverett, who's your underdog pick of the week?
You know what? I think
dogs,
the Bills.
Dogs, dogs.
I think the Buffalo Bills are going to. I think the Buffalo Bills are going to pull off a stunner.
Boo that man.
Boo.
Boo.
No. Matt Milano, sleeper pick. He's going to have
what
2 interceptions.
BC,
and...
you fucking shitbag.
So, fun fact about Matt Milano.
What do you
fun
fact,
why don't you, why don't you take your skank wife and get the fuck
out
of here?
Rachel
Fisher
on Instagram, and that's
can I call
like
a timeout?
I've been waiting to call a timeout all night.
I have a comment. So, fun fact about Matt Milano. As you know, he's a BC guy. When I was at Curry, I worked at a bar right down the street from the BC campus called Cityside Bar. We actually had to throw him out one time when he was a BC football player. So at the time he was like a nobody, but look at what he became. We are the people who taught him. Like, that was his turning point. He's like, I just got kicked out of a bar by a bunch of pussies. Like, I need to become a man and accept the challenge and grow up. We made Matt Milano who he is. No bullshit. We actually kicked him out one night.
Bottom line, Matt Milano should have stayed in the truck.
Yeah.
Bang. No. All right. So my next pick. I mean, Minshew was already ready to blow this game so we win money. Leverett's not a big gambler.
Falcons.
I'm going to get back to it. The game of the year, the NFC East Championship, the Dallas Cowboys. Big shout out to my boy Jimmy Essence. Great guy. And not a big shout out to Philadelphia Eagles because fuck Philly. I'm going to take Dallas at -1 over Philly to win the NFC East Championship. They're going to be in the first round against either Seattle and San Fran, and they're going to get pumped. But this weekend, they're going to pull it out in Philly and in Lincoln Financial Field and get it done in front of all of this faithful.
Knox going Saints -2 over the Titans. Saints, they're feeling it right now. Drew Brees is going to come in hot. -2 can't be stopped. Yeah, damn it.
Dude, Mike Vrabel, this is a win and go home game. You're going to bet against Mike Vrabel?
I'm going to bet against Ryan Tannehill. Still Ryan Tannehill. Got to bet against him. Don't care what he's
are you joined here for a reason, Anton? So what's
Thanks
going on?
Thanks for the invite, guys. Glad to be back. you know, I just wanted to give three picks.
Welcome.
Three picks.
All right, then you give one, then we'll keep going.
No, but I'm just going to give three real quick. Okay. That's all I'm going to be doing. I'll stop. You know why? Because I have been looking at this Saturday board, looking. Love this Saturday board. DFS. Haven't even looked at Sunday yet because I've been looking at the Saturday board so much that I love it. I don't care.
DraftKings.
I don't care. No, I'm giving you bets.
I'm just kidding.
You can go. Tampa Bay versus Houston. Probably two of the worst pass defenses in the league. I think Houston's the second worst against fantasy players in the league besides Arizona Cardinals.
So what's your pick? I like your analysis, but what's your pick?
The over. I don't care if it's 115. I'm taking the over. The over.
Hammer it.
So how many pick? All right, how many Jameis Winston pick sixes? At least one.
Oh my god!
Nah, pick six. I think we're gonna get four touchdowns, two interceptions. I think OJ Howard has a great day. I think Cameron Brate scores a touchdown. Perriman, he had three touchdowns on six targets. So he's not gonna repeat that.
I know
again.
You're a DFS guy, but I picked him up for my fantasy team in championship. You think that's a good idea?
Yeah, I do because only this is why. Scotty Miller and Godwin are up.
I'd like to interject with a Jameis Winston comment. We keep talking about him. Jameis Winston, he always throws pick sixes. Like during his drive to the stadium, we talked about all his questionable off the field activity. The police, during his drive to the stadium, the police are gonna intercept him and run him back to jail where he belongs.
Love that.
And whoever's second string on their depth chart will be in there, you know, throwing the ball to the correct team.
I'm going
to
have Leverett Ball throwing the ball, baby.
I'm going to have him in, like, literally at least 30% of my DraftKings lineup, so I hope not.
Okay. Well, I'm going to make my
– but back to my pick because I haven't made my fucking pick.
You said you picked the over.
Oh, the over I did.
Picked the over.
All right.
So my last pick before I pick my dog, I got Baltimore 9.5. Minus, like, their favorite over Cleveland. I think Cleveland's already burned to the ground, and there's nothing else to pick up from it. I think Lamar Jackson might even be out of this game by halftime. I think this is going to be a 42-10 stinker. Baker Mayfield is going to have to figure out next year that the diva wide receivers are talking about, oh, hey, no, we'll get him next year. There's 2 weeks left, buddy. Why don't you figure it out and join the Gardner Minshew clan where they're still winning games. Big shout-out to Gardner over there. He took a seat, but he's ready to go.
Question for you. Is when do we start comparing Baker Mayfield to Johnny Manziel as a giant failure?
Give him another year. You need one more year.
Baker Mayfield has not done drugs in the locker room or punched his girlfriend.
You don't know anything about that.
As far as we know.
I'm just saying.
We know Jameis Winston's a piece of shit. We don't know that about Baker Mayfield.
Has Johnny Manziel been tackled by a cop? Probably, but Baker Mayfield definitely has.
Johnny Manziel would sleep off his hangovers in the equipment room, and he bursts his girlfriend's
hangovers. You think it's just a hangover?
How does Baker do that his rookie year to this? He's got some hangovers. I mean,
Steele, what's your final pick?
San Fran's putting a stake in the fucking Rams. They're
6.5?
Yeah.
Ooh, I like that. Yeah. I like that. Defense going to step up. Jared Goff might be the worst quarterback in the league. I would take Andy Ginger fuck Dalton over fucking Jared Goff. Rumble.
Doesn't 6.5 scare you a little bit though? That's like just like I'm everybody.
No, that's why you gotta hit it.
They come to play.
That's when
everybody
loses. The only thing they'll
come back to you on. I know it's at Levi's Field in San Fran.
It is.
No, but that field is named after. But the Rams play a lot better. Oh, that's a good one. The Rams play a lot better with divisional opponents. So. That's going to be a tough one. But, yo, I'm riding with you there, man. Look at that moose.
I'm not touching that.
Look at that moose. That's a great ugly sweater there. I like
that's
that.
A cow. Like,
oh, Fuck. They hate to see that.
That's not get out of
it. I remember. I haven't given my other two picks.
Then you come next to us.
Am I in the camera?
Maybe, but you can be a VO.
You literally like
How
directly.
Did you think that was a moose.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know.
What a fucking jackass.
Too much of this pick, pick Whitney, you know.
Me. What a jabroni.
All right, my next pick. Thanks. My next pick. Patriots Bills. Is this an underdog pick yet? Yeah, it is. Under. 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 Under.
That's the easiest pick money can buy. I agree with you. I
love it,
Anton. We're related. Everything's like that, and I couldn't agree with you more on this pick. In New England, in Foxborough, with the cold, I'm taking the under.
Love it.
What's your analysis?
I'm thinking. I think. I don't even think it's even come close. I would. I'll literally. If it was under 34. 34 is the line. I think 37 and a half, right?
Yeah.
If it was under 34, 33 and a half, I'll take the under. I think it's 17, 14, 17, 10, 14. I think it's horrible. Our offense isn't going to hit anything. I mean, we haven't been great, especially against good defenses. Bill have a great defense. Sony Michel sucks.
I mean, I'm not going to bring
Edelman's banged up.
I'm not going to bring up how good I do with gambling, but last Sunday, Bills Steelers, I was like, okay, the Bills will probably win that game 17 to 10. So why not bet them winning seven and 10?
What's James White's status heading into the game? Is he healthy? So he's going to be like their positionless player because they have no receivers. They're going to throw to him. They're going to hand off to him. You know, who the fuck knows? He's going to do everything.
They
he's
can't
be
run up the
guy.
Middle. They right. can't run up the middle. Their offensive line stinks.
And
a lot of their players on offense stink.
The secondary against Josh Allen that I thought was better than he's been playing is you know, Stephon, that's the best secondary in the league, the Patriots. So that's not even a homer pick. I'm not a homer guy. If Devin Singletary can gash us like Mixon, then maybe. But
that was tough.
It's going to be a way under. It's not even going to be
Mixon
close.
Mixon went off. That was tough.
So now the dogs pick of the night, underdogs. I'm going to go. They're 4-0 when they're plus 260 underdogs in the air. I looked up that stat today. It's a fact.
Love this.
Oakland Raiders on the road against the L.A. Chargers. And Phil Rivers is already on like his 12th like kid. Like he the season's over. He's like 5-8 or something. Like I couldn't believe this like money line. It's like Derek Carr needs to like play well for him to be the starting quarterback in Vegas. Like I'm taking Oakland plus 260. Phillip That's a Rivers, no-brainer. Yeah. That's the easiest
why?
Money to buy.
That makes
I don't get it.
It's like Derek Carr just got booed off. They're about to boo off Phillip Rivers as his last fucking
Phillip Rivers
game.
Is not known for his pullout game. Like the joke I made earlier about like changing your name because you can't pull out. His name used to be Felipe Rivers. He used to play soccer.
But this team, I'm saying John Gruden's not. I mean, they still have a like outside playoff spot. Like they're not going to make it, but they got to keep winning. Like they got to win the next two games. Steele, do you have a dog pick?
Go Pack, go.
Ooh, against the
Vikings. It's in Minnesota, but, like, I just think...
Vikings a favorite?
Game. Yes, they are.
Okay.
And, like...
It's an interesting one.
There's just, I don't know. That Kirk Cousins?
No, doesn't win that game.
Big game. Just can't... Don't see him doing it.
Yeah, the Packers team's boom or bust, you know. It's
either
going to be very right or very wrong.
What's your last pick here, Anton? You got any more picks?
Yeah, I'm going to give you my final over-under for the Saturday games. It's... What do we got? Rams 49ers?
Yes, I believe so.
This guy drips. This guy drips sex. Honestly, look at how good he comes on the show.
Oh, yeah.
I'll let you go, but that's what we call dripping sex.
Oh fuck
Mr.
yeah,
Mr. Ball.
Dude, actually, he looks like a kid I went to Curry with. Nazz went to Curry before he transferred. Do you remember Nick Wheeler?
I didn't know you went
Did
to school with Brad Pitt.
No, but do you remember Nick Wheeler? He looks like Nick Wheeler. Like, because
Nick Wheeler
would, like, wear fresh suits and shit. You're a better human being, though. Like, Nick Wheeler is kind of a douchebag, but he had fresh suits. You're, like, a nicer Nick Wheeler. You're, like, handsome and a good person.
Give him a few Tito's sodas.
Turns out he killed a guy. Yeah.
Sprite. Is that what he's dragging his
Go
company.
To Providence.
Sorry.
Sponsored by 7-Eleven.
Sorry I messed up your Saturday pick.
Yeah,
what's your Saturday pick?
Just trying to compliment.
Oh, I'm going to do a final over-under. Just saying.
You going over-under?
I don't know if this is supposed to like this.
I really want to go under. I really do. Cause
there
I
you go.
I that's where
Where's the root,
I
baby?
Want to go under.
Look,
I
look
really
at this
want to.
I gotta bounce
up. I wanna say Jared Goff's gonna get absolutely mangled. I wanna say Jared Goff can't play against good defense. A really good 49ers defense. But I love how they're incorporating Gurley into the offense. Cooper Kupp is kinda back.
And
Cooper Kupp is not back. He scored a backdoor touchdown. That there wouldn't be the fantasy matchup last week, but he is not back. They got murdered by a horrible team in the Cowboys.
Right. Now you're scouting this offense. Now you're looking at this Rams offense. He has that upside. He's gonna. Because you still have Cooks and you still have Robert Woods.
Over.
I love their weapons over there. It's an over.
I agree with you. A childish schoolgirl, but it's
the
over.
I agree with you. I think who's the 49ers there? Emmanuel Sanders is going to get shadowed by Ramsey. He's going to do nothing. But then they have Kittle and Debo, and Mostert's very good. I think it's an over.
So we're going to go over on the Niners-Rams game. Hey, Leverett, I just want to take time, man. I really appreciate you coming all the way to come on this show, man. It's been a great time.
Let me just say this.
Yeah.
So I did a pre-taped radio show yesterday that's on the radio right now. So I missed out on tugging myself to my own voice to be here. And one of the five girls I talked to on Tinder today, that's not a great average, but one of the five girls on Tinder I talked to today was down. So I missed tugging myself.
How much did she weigh?
Quite a bit.
Great line, tugging myself.
But I missed tugging myself to my own voice or getting tugged to be here. That's how much it meant to me. Thank you for having me.
That's my guy right there.
Yeah, high fives all around. He criticized my high-fiving abilities earlier. High fives all around. Woo!
I'm going to go tug myself.
Yeah.
You want to get tugged? We'll tug you. We'll do a little circle jerk right here. Right now.
Rookie hazing. First time on the show.
Yeah, that's what we do when we wrap up.
Big shout out to J.R. McEvely.
If you're the new guy,
J.R. McEvely.
Yeah, I had a hockey pickup game the other day, and I was playing defense, and he comes up to me. He said, "Yo, if I score the game-winning goal, can you announce me on Steele Nazz? Give me a shout-out." Okay. I was like, yeah, so John Ross McEvely, if everyone wants to know, shout-out to you, baby. So thanks, folks, for tuning in. Really appreciate it. If anyone would like to write for our blog, I mean, we got a lot of stuff going on at Quincy right now. If you guys want to purchase any T-shirts, those are on the way as well. We're in the holiday swing of things. Just let us know, man. We're always here, baby, every other week. That's all from Steele and Nazz. Merry Christmas.
Happy holidays.
And if you want to get pissed, happy holidays. Bang.
Here comes Magic Mike. Here comes Magic Mike right down Hancock Street. Steele and Nazz and Anton Touche. Shlomo, give me the beat. Beers are flowing, hoes are hoeing. All is merry and bright. If you're naughty, come and party, it's magic time tonight. Here comes Magic Mike, here comes Magic Mike, right down South Beach Lane. Chip is here, Mike Live fears, someone call Lights Out Lang. Hats of buckets, ears of suckers, oh what a wonderful sight. Let's get rowdy, come say howdy, it's magic time tonight. Here comes Magic Mike, here comes Magic Mike, save a seat at the pub. Decade ending, current bartending, come on, join the club. Light on my sled, that's what she said, oh, what a delight. I best believe in, if you believe in, magic's coming tonight. Here comes Magic Mike, here comes Magic Mike, right down Hancock Street. Steele Nazz and Anton Touche, Shlomo, give me the beat. Beers are flowing, hoes are hoeing, all is merry and bright. If you're naughty, come and party, it's magic time tonight.